How to achieve self-mastery. We got a quick one for you here today. We're gonna go over a few things on at least what I think help people become mastered. The first of which is that it's gotta be past yourself, right? It's gotta be for other people, at least in some part, because when it comes down to it, we're all so interconnected. So if you do something just for you, it's not gonna benefit other people. If you're not helping others, I think this is a Will Smith quote, if you're not helping others, then you're wasting your time. Now, I might slash that out and put willpower, but you get the picture. So when we have that deeper desire that's almost altruistic in some sense, then that gives us this deeper passion and kind of tied in discipline to allow us to go through the hard times, to sidestep and overcome the difficulties that we might not be able to if we don't approach it with this grander scheme in place. If you want to be self-mastered, help other people. But how are you gonna do that? And there's a little bit more that I wanna go into. Okay, so self-mastery is more than just helping other people. Very much like when the oxygen masks come down from airplanes, right? The whole goal is to put it on yourself first so that you can then help other people. If you can't help yourself, you can't help others, right? It's creating this kind of ongoing pool, this unending well of energy to give, right? And you can't do that if you're not sustaining yourself. So for me, that looks like meditating, exercising, eating healthy, things like that that allow me to sustain whatever I'm doing so that I can help others. Now, if I'm not doing those things, then I have very little left to give. And I'm sure that most of you have some similar things. It might not be those behaviors for you. It might be reading or gratitude journals or whatever, but we need to find those things that allow us to feel sustained by ourselves so that we can help others. I think that's the kind of foundation to living a mastered life. Okay, the next thing I want to go over for self-mastery is looking at our brain slash body slash mind, heart, soul, whatever, this that we are, as our vehicle, okay? This is our way to get there. This is the engine or the process that allows us to progress. And if we're not focused on this machinery that we have here, and we're just trying to look at the external and change the external, then we're not gonna really be successful, okay? We need to change ourselves first. Don't change the world, first change yourself. And I think that's an absurdly important thing to share, to promulgate, to put out there and continue spreading, because it's so true. If we expect to change the external before trying to change the internal, then we're going about it backwards, which is why we try to guide you through in some other videos some introspection, right? How do I actually confront this reality that I'm in and understand that this is my vehicle for change? It's all about the process, not the path, right? It's the journey, not the destination, okay? And if we create a vehicle that can traverse any sort of terrain, anything that life throws at us, sinkholes, potholes, like barricades in our way, if we can go through them, then we're setting ourselves up much better off than if we were to just be like, okay, this is the path I'm taking, regardless of what obstacle. We need to be these adaptable, maneuverable things that can shape around, like almost like these shapeshifters that go through life. That way, if we can be like water, to quote Bruce Lee, then we're gonna be so much better off, right? Anything that comes our way, we can cope with, we can deal with, we can figure out how to move past. The final part I wanna go over here is the necessity for having passion and purpose to progress. Now, you can progress to an extent without those things, but in order to really get to that deep level of success in terms of behaving the way you intend to, for whatever value you're trying to make real, you need this passion, this underlying deeper purpose, which is why we tried to begin with helping other people, as that's kind of the goal, right? If we can all live in harmony and are improving each other, right? Mirror neuron system, everything we do with other people gets picked up by them and vice versa in some way. So the more that we can better ourselves and better other people, it just makes the whole that much better. And here's a quick reframe, because I think mastery implies perfection in some way. And perfection is really the enemy when it comes to starting and restarting, right? Starting is the game. Restarting is the game. Okay, if you think about meditation, you know, you're supposed to focus on your breath, at least in some forms, And if you drift off, that's okay. You just start again, right? That's the whole idea. It's never going to be perfect. We just have to keep at it, keep going, keep putting one foot in front of the other to allow us the best chance at progress, right? If that's our ultimate goal is progress, then we have to be persistent and determined in some sense. So trying to be perfect is not the way to go. Here's a quick story on how I really came to this realization. So in high school, I was a baseball player and had a hitting coach, and they told me, how do you want to swing? I was like, I don't know, good. Like, I want to have a good swing. Like, no, you want a perfect swing. And how do you get perfection? Practice? He said, perfect practice. Okay, cool. Like, at the time, I was like, all right, that sounds cool. That's a cool phrase. I like that. But, you know, later on in life, I go, holy, once I started learning about growth mindset, fixed mindset, all that stuff, it became really clear to me that that's a losing battle. That's a non-starter, because you can't ever have the perfect swing, first of all. So if you're trying to get that from the start, you're never going to start. You're not going to be invigorated or encouraged to practice, because you can never attain that thing that you're after. Now, maybe that works for you. I don't want to put my biases on you, but the approach that's worked for me better is looking at improvement as the goal. How can I swing, in this case, better than my previous swing? And that entails a lot of introspection, a lot of analysis of, okay, what did I actually not do here that I want to do next time? Or what can I do even better that I did well here, but I really want to double down on this? Okay, so that looking within, that awareness, that courage to confront the realities of, I'm actually not perfect right now. How do I get better? And being okay with progress, as small as it might be or feel, or maybe it doesn't feel like anything is happening for you. But progress is like bamboo. I know this sounds cliche and all that, but bamboo takes 5 years or so to create the root system. But once it has that root system established, then it just shoots up. But until it breaks ground, it seems like nothing's happening. It seems like all this effort and deliberate action is not being realized, so it's a waste of time, it's a waste of effort. Why am I doing this? But if you understand that the mechanism for it is, look, it takes a lot of time to actually start working, and then once it does, it is unstoppable. That's the kind of meta-awareness that we need of our process to allow us to realize our deepest passions. So self-mastery is not only this game of persistence, but it's also this game of knowing, hey, this will pay off if I keep at it. And here's how to get even better and even better and even better. Okay, progress is that underlying engine towards our better life. I can only say this from my perspective and what I've read and how my mind works and all that stuff, but I'm assuming that this can be helpful to some of you. Especially when I was a little bit younger, this type of material would have helped me a lot. So that's kind of why I'm making it. So if it doesn't resonate with you, sorry, but I hope it does. Okay, so with that, I will leave you to your YouTube watching, and have a good day/life. I'll see you later.